MIDI is a common tool used in the process of music composition because it offers the composer incredible speed and flexibility. MIDI also has a small data footprint, something that's highly desirable in game audio, so it's understandable that the ability to work with MIDI is integrated into Wwise. We'll use MIDI to enhance one of the music segments that plays when the player meets the big boss. We'll later import a file that's an additional track that will play over what we already have prepared for the A section. Let's take a quick listen. The track being added is a special synthesizer-based part, composed and delivered as a standard MIDI file. Standard MIDI files are a universal file type that can be exchanged by most MIDI sequencing systems. Note that to use MIDI in Wwise, MIDI sequences must first be created elsewhere using any of the many MIDI sequencing DAW applications. But once the resulting standard MIDI files are imported into Wwise, those MIDI recordings can take advantage of workflows very similar to that of working with audio. The main difference is that MIDI on its own doesn't produce any sound, so the imported MIDI files must be directed to an object within Wwise that can produce sound, like the Synth1 synthesizer we'll use later in this tutorial. Even though MIDI files are not technically audio files, the process of adding a MIDI sequence as an additional music track begins the same way. We'll first right-click the Boss A music segment and choose Import Audio Files, and then click the Add Files button. And in this case, we'll import the Boss A arpeggio. We can see it's tiny in size, not even 2 kilobytes. And we see that the MIDI file will be imported as a music track, just as if it was audio. The new track appears in the Music Segment Editor. However, the clip displays a series of horizontal lines instead of an audio waveform. This is similar to the piano roll type editor in a conventional music sequencer. Each of these lines represents a single note's length and pitch. While MIDI clips can be moved and trimmed just as you've done with audio clips, it is not possible to edit the individual MIDI note attributes like pitch and length, so make sure the parts are finalized before importing them. Remember that on their own, MIDI tracks don't make any sound. If we solo and play the MIDI track, we're not going to hear anything. Within Wwise, you have a few options to derive sound from MIDI music tracks. In this tutorial, we'll use Synth1, a source plugin synthesizer within Wwise. Synth1 contains the basic features you would expect from any synthesizer, such as multiple oscillators, envelopes, LFO control, and more. Because Synth1 is a source plugin, it needs to be housed within a sound SFX object, which is then targeted by the MIDI music track. Think of it like hooking a MIDI cable from the physical output of a sequencer to the physical input of a hardware synthesizer. To start, we'll create a new work unit within the Actor Mixer hierarchy that will house all of the objects that deal with the music system. So we'll go to the Actor Mixer hierarchy folder, right-click, choose New Child, Work Unit, and we'll call it Music. Now within it, we'll right-click, choose New Child. Here we can see that it's possible to choose Wwise Synth1. We see the Wwise Synth1 source editor appear, and we see the various properties related to sound synthesis. Be sure to check out the tutorial specifically on Synth1 to learn more about these features. We also see in the Actor Mixer hierarchy the new sound SFX object. Let's rename it by right-clicking, choose Rename, and we'll call this Arpeggio Synth. Down in the transport, we can play the new synthesizer. Currently, it will play the same tone every time. This is because the frequency mode is set to bass frequency, and that frequency is set to 1000 Hz. In this mode, the synth will only play sounds at this specified frequency. The result we need is for the pitch to be dictated by the position of the MIDI note being played. Change the frequency mode to MIDI note, and we'll play again. The default pitch now plays much lower. Now we need to connect the Boss A arpeggio MIDI music track to the arpeggio synth sound SFX object. We'll close the source editor. In the interactive music hierarchy, we'll expand the Boss A music playlist container and select the Boss A arpeggio music track we just imported. In order for this track to target the arpeggio synth, we need to access properties in a MIDI tab in the Property Editor, and by default, the MIDI tab may not be displayed. We'll add it by clicking the plus symbol in the Property Editor, and then selecting the MIDI checkbox. Now we can click the MIDI tab. The MIDI target area indicates where the MIDI data played from a music track will be directed. We can see in the MIDI target area that there currently is no assignment. The unassigned condition of this property is being inherited from the parent object, so we'll need to override the parent setting to be able to make an assignment. Now we can make our assignment by dragging the desired arpeggio synth sound SFX object from the actor mixer hierarchy to the MIDI target property, and the connection is made. To test it, play the Boss A music segment. And we now hear that a new sound has been added to the mix. Now that you know how to connect a MIDI sequence with Synth 1, be sure to check out the other video tutorial in this series that explores the various features of Synth 1 so that you can customize the sound it produces.